When at the recent Golden Globe Awards, the host Ricky Gervais joked that Leonardo DiCaprio's girlfriends are too old even for Prince Andrew, not everyone laughed. Maybe the Hollywood elite is not aware of the scandals surrounding the British royal family. But anyway, those events seem to have serious consequences. Despite the fact that Prince Andrew stepped back from the public eye, because of him, Princess Beatrice's wedding may not even take place. So what led to this? Will the father's actions really ruin the most beautiful day in the life of the granddaughter of the queen? Keep watching to find out what will happen with Princess Beatrice's wedding, and don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more juicy news. If you keep up with our channel, you've probably heard about the scandal that involved Prince Andrew, and according to the British media, the son of Elizabeth II caused the greatest crisis in the royal family since the death of Princess Diana. If you don't remember this controversy, let's have a quick review. Prince Andrew is the third child of Queen Elizabeth II, and he's the eighth in line to the British throne. For many years, he was considered the black sheep of the family because of his behavior after he divorced Sarah Ferguson in 1996. The prince partied with multiple women, spent loads of money, engaged in shady business, and hung around inappropriate people. One of them was Jeffrey Epstein, an American billionaire financier who was sentenced for having inappropriate relations with underage girls and trafficking young women. While waiting for the next trial, Epstein was found dead in his prison cell. But what's worse was among the clients of the businessman, there appeared the name of Prince Andrew. And if that wasn't enough, one of the victims, Virginia Jeffrey, revealed that in 2005, that years before, she was forced to have sexual contact with Prince Andrew, and she was barely 17 years old. Let's not forget that the father of the Princess Eugene and Princess Beatrice strongly denied having any contacts with Mrs. Jeffrey, then Roberts. There's just one small detail. On the internet, you can find photos of Prince Andrew embracing the then 17-year-old girl in a London house belonging to Ghislaine Maxwell, Epstein's ex-girlfriend and personal assistant. Do you think that's all? Oh, definitely not. To put an end to all the rumors, in November, Prince Andrew gave an interview to the BBC where he answered questions about Epstein. The whole thing was really embarrassing. Of course, we have a detailed video about it, so make sure to check it out. In the interview, Prince Andrew actually admitted that he was so friendly with the billionaire that in 2006, he invited Epstein to the 18th birthday party of his daughter, Princess Beatrice. According to Andrew, he had no idea that an arrest warrant had been issued for the businessman earlier that year for assaulting a minor. And who would have thought that years later, Prince Andrew's actions would fire back like that, and what's more important is that they would ruin his daughter's most important day. But before we get to this, I have to tell you that the interview that was supposed to fix the image of the Queen's son not only became a national joke for the British viewers, it's also been branded a PR disaster. And after the interview had been broadcast, key sponsors and supporters of Andrew's charity started rethinking their involvement with him and gave up further support for the prince's projects. So, because of the mess he made, a few days after the interview aired, Andrew issued a statement in which he announced that he's quitting public duties for the foreseeable future following the suspension by his mother. The prince justified his decision by saying that he wanted to protect the image of the monarchy and not to disturb the work of the royal family through the connection to Jeffrey Epstein. The queen gave her permission for Andrew to step back, and the prince also said that he would help any law enforcement agencies with their investigation if needed. But these aren't all the consequences that Prince Andrew had to face. As a result of his withdrawal from public duties, the son of Queen Elizabeth II will no longer get the salary that the active members of the royal family do. And following the statement, Andrew's private offices were removed from Buckingham Palace. As if that wasn't enough, the residents of Inverness started a petition asking the Queen to strip Andrew of the title of Earl of Inverness, while the monarch herself cancelled her son's 60th birthday party planned for February 2020. And what's more, the Duke of York didn't attend the reception for the NATO leaders hosted by the Queen at Buckingham Palace, and he didn't turn up to the public Christmas service at Sandringham Church with the rest of the royal family. Prince Andrew was spotted walking with Prince Charles to the chapel for an earlier service though. Later, Kate, William, and their kids stole all the attention when they went out to greet the royal fans. Will keeping a low profile influence the image of the monarchy and help Prince Andrew deal with all the controversy? I don't think so. It turns out that his actions strongly affected his loved ones, but let me tell you what's going on now. Well, in September of 2019, the Buckingham Palace, on behalf of the Duke and Duchess of York, announced the engagement of their older daughter, Princess Beatrice. The princess's fiancé is the multi-millionaire Edoardo Mapelli Mozzi, a divorced businessman, the founder and CEO of Banda Property, a real estate company. We also have a video all about this lovely couple. The fiancé of the granddaughter of the Queen, Elizabeth, proposed to her during the holidays in Italy, and their wedding is set to take place in 2020. And although it's supposed to be the most beautiful day in the life of the daughter of the Duchess of York, it seems that because of Andrew's actions, it may not be as happy as expected. So what consequences will Prince Andrew's scandal have for the princess? First of all, Beatrice cancelled her engagement party, which was scheduled for December of 2019. Apparently, the princess called off the event because she didn't want her guests to be bothered by the paparazzi, who would have been waiting for her father. Instead of an official party, as reported by Us Weekly, the couple organized a small gathering for their loved ones in their friend's apartment. But it's not confirmed whether the Duke and Duchess of York or the Queen were there. Another thing is whether Prince Andrew will walk his daughter down the aisle, and if the fans of the royal family will get photos or live broadcasts from the wedding ceremony. After all, when in October of 2018, the younger daughter of Prince Andrew, Princess Eugene, married Jack Brooksbank in St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle, her father not only walked her down the aisle, but the British TV broadcast the ceremony live. Of course, this event wasn't as huge as the royal wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle just half a year earlier. But still, many celeb guests were present. For instance, Kate Moss, Naomi Campbell, Demi Moore, Ellie Goulding, and Robbie Williams with his wife. But it wasn't BBC that aired Princess Eugene's wedding. The channel, which has the rights to show important royal family events for free, refused to broadcast it because they expected ratings to be low. The ceremony was shown on ITV, a commercial channel which, according to The Independent, strongly supported Prince Andrew, and when it comes to the ratings, the event attracted 3 million viewers. So what will it be like for Beatrice? It's already been announced that neither BBC nor ITV will broadcast the ceremony. Royal experts say that this may be because of the controversy surrounding Prince Andrew, and that because of this, the ceremony will be private. Due to the controversy involving the son of the Queen Elizabeth II, we don't know much about Beatrice's wedding preparations. Buckingham Palace still refuses to comment, and neither the date nor the place of the ceremony has been confirmed. It's rumored that the couple will tie the knot at the end of May, or early in June, or as Express reports, in September. It's probably because they don't want their celebration to interfere with the Royal Ascot horse racing, and allegedly, the wedding will also take place in St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle. The family of the Duke of York revealed that the couple has never wanted a large celebration. Are they saying this because Beatrice's engagement and wedding are still overshadowed by the Andrew thing? As experts say, including the royal biographer Christopher Warwick, because of the Epstein scandal, Beatrice and Edoardo may be forced to organize a private wedding or a much smaller ceremony than Eugene and Jack Brookbank. And then, the wedding won't take place where William and Kate got married because a much better venue would be the All Saints Chapel. A former BBC correspondent, Jenny Bond, also says that the massive disapproval from the British public was caused by the fact that during Eugene's wedding, about $2.6 million from the taxpayers' money was spent on security. And as the journalist claims, with all the hassle around Beatrice's ceremony, the royal family may want to change the plans to protect the princess from negative comments. Another royal expert and author, Marlene Koenig, tweeted that Beatrice's wedding will be collateral damage of her father's scandal, and that she wouldn't be surprised if the princess decided to have a quiet wedding out of the public eye, with a few photos and no live coverage. And according to Koenig, this is a better solution than postponing the wedding. However, according to iNews and more royal experts, Prince Andrew agreed to the BBC interview just to fix his image before his daughter's wedding, so that he can proudly walk her down the aisle. As we know, the interview had the opposite effect. What's more, Beatrice and her sister Eugene didn't release any public statements after their father's interview. Only their mother, Sarah Ferguson, published a post on her Instagram supporting her ex-husband. But to possibly fix the situation as a gesture of solidarity, the Queen invited Edoardo Mapelli Mozzi to spend Christmas with the whole family in Sandringham. This is quite important because just recently the monarch changed the rules regarding the stay of unmarried couples on the Norfolk estate. But as noted by body language experts, Princess Beatrice looked confident and happy during the traditional royal family walk in Sandringham. Has Prince Andrew just ruined the most beautiful day of his daughter's life? Or maybe Queen Elizabeth II, who is the guard of the image of the monarchy, will come up with something to fix this situation? Make sure to leave your thoughts in the comments. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to Curious Sips to stay up to date with our channel. And if you like this video, share it with your friends. Until next time.